I'd like to hand it over to Abha, who will introduce some aspects of this program.
I'm very involved with it for almost a year now. And it's really nice to see all the faces who, many of whom we know personally, are passionate about training and training towards taking all of us towards a better environment and towards the rule of law. My association with policing, like Maya said, I'm a lawyer, and so therefore the law is the route that I know best to making things, improving things. And my association with the police has been very, very enriching. And I do owe a lot of it to Mr. V.N. Rai, who's sitting here, because he gave us a very, very open space to introduce new concepts, which are concepts which are new in training, initially in the Haryana Police Academy, and then I also got a chance to be faculty at the National Police Academy, where again there was a turn in the way that training was done, what I saw when I was there. So I was... and besides that, you know, the whole engagement with the community, which as Mrs. Seth has also been my chair when I was the director of MARG, and I equally owe her a lot, because that was a platform where we got to engage a lot with the community. So it was all of that that one tries to then bring together, because training has to be a synthesis of the user and the supplier. And in a sense, a policeman is a user of the thana, but in a sense, the client or the user is actually the public. So here was a tool, and Maya's organization, CHRI, I've been associated with them since 1997, and they really offer these fantastic platforms to do all sorts of work. It's a very open platform, which is the best part about any platform. It has to be open and, you know, be welcome new ideas and work towards that. So when, like Maya said, you know, when the minute I saw this, it was presented, and we were three or four of us at this. I mean, it was just a few minutes that, I mean, I said, okay, yes. Yes, yes, and yes, and now we started working on it. So this is a training tool which basically it addresses two things. One is that it's a jump up. As you can see, the tagline is it's the new generation of training, right? So it's the next generation of training. And the other thing is that the content itself. So we use a lot of content. Sometimes what we call content is not really content. It's only rhetoric. I mean, that's the interface somehow between civil society and an organization like the police. What I have observed is that while rhetoric, experiences, everything is very important, but making that crucial link, making that important link with the law, with the rules, that how the sense of rights is already inbuilt into the law. So it's not that you have to look separately, you know, to do rights-based policing. So in this tool, we've tried to synthesize both. We've tried to cover the gap, firstly, in training. So as a trainer, what I've seen in various police academies, there are two kinds of, I mean, so mostly it's either it's the faculty that is the trainer, or you have very short exposures to visiting faculty. So the faculty, what one sees is that perhaps there's a need to do that also, that they generally reinforce, not through any conscious effort, but they're basically reinforcing whatever is the problem with policing. So because they're also deep into it, and you can't really step out wildly and start you know, presenting bizarre things which people will find pretty shocking when they go back to the thana. So one is that. The second is the methodology, which is what this tool really, it's a huge jump. Because the methodology, what one generally observes is that it's lectures. And the lectures by themselves are not, I mean, they don't really set the classroom on fire. They are pretty boring. And the best compliment that one can get in a police training is, you know, at the end of the lecture, somebody tells you, koi bhi soya nahi. So that's your big hit. You mean that you've really, you know, done a good job of it if your class hasn't slept. Otherwise, you have to keep, you know, somebody will keep coming up and coming up to the podium and saying, class, sadhan bet. And then you have to restart and cover something else. So this is something really important because, you know, the just the lack of training methodology in most of the police training one sees is really abysmal. I mean, I really don't know why more work or more focus hasn't been done on this, because things like case studies and a few visuals, audio visuals, are very easy to get and all. But we normally have training faculty which will read out slides of sections on the PowerPoint. So, which is really disappointing, and I just hope that this will not only by itself be useful, but it will also help people to imagine a better way or a better standard of training. The other thing is about content. So content, like I said, it swings somewhere between rhetoric and a very dry presentation of the law. Because if the police is not working or training itself in the law, it's not doing anything. But what I found is that the understanding of the law, I mean primarily the CRPC and the police rules, the understanding is from a very different perspective. So they understand the section, they even know the sections by heart, but what's the spirit of the section? Why is the section so? For example, you know, filing an FIR. There is so much resistance to it. It starts with the resistance, and the resistance then spills over always and continues throughout the career for some reason. So it seems like the CRPC is not seen as an implementation of Article 21 and 22 of the Constitution of India. It's seen as a power. The arrest is not seen as an implementation of Article 21. But when you ask in a class full of policemen, aapka CRPC mein aapko sabse achhi dhara kaun si lagti hai, they say dhara 41, section 41, which is the power to arrest. A lot of the training has to change to what it ought to be and to synthesize not just the spirit and the letter of the law, but also to synthesize what in practical terms they are going to be doing down at the police station. So because it can't be that in the training room at the training academy, everything is very sweet and beautiful and this is how you should be doing things, but it comes as a huge shock when you go down to the police station and you're not able to do. But that is the feedback that you get. But I think very successfully that was managed. I have one example from the Haryana Police Academy that was very successfully managed with a team of people who were actually tuned into sensitized policing. But when they went down to do field work, so it was not in a laboratory atmosphere, but when they went down to the field to manage a police station, they were able to actually practice those things. So which reinforced and it thing. So about now this particular tool, it brings in people's experiences at the police station. It brings in what normally you hear about an experience at the police station, which is unfortunately never a flattering, you know, people just don't recall it. Some people, of course, but then again, there's an imbalance there because not everybody has a bad experience at the police station, but what comes out in the public, to the public mind and what the public gets to hear is the bad experience. So a training tool like this would also set right that balance, because people need to get inside and see what's going on, because a person comes at 10 a.m. to file an FIR, and by 11 or 12 o'clock, if the FIR is filed, at 2 o'clock, that person wants results. But that's not how a police station functions, or that's not how it ought to function. I mean, there is a time thing, because and there is a process taking place. So once you introduce people to telling them, look, when your complaint comes, it's like it's all these whole rooms full of registers. What are they doing? They're not just there for show. So we've opened up many of these registers to show the public that, look, whatever you, your complaint now moves from here, it gets entered here, it gets entered here, and through that, we're ensuring that there is an outcome. And that would help, so once the people know, at least, you know, that helps them to understand what's going on, it makes people patient, it makes the police more accountable. If the, if you know, because then you can demand that, you know, what happened to this, at least you know that this is going to happen. So, in different steps, at different stages, we've just tried to take away the dread of a police station. We've tried to make it more practical to the person who's going to be manning the police station so that the person at the induction level, this would be a great training tool, because at an induction level, I think a person who goes into the police force knows just about as much as a common person knows. So it's takes you around. It tells you the philosophy behind any particular process, and it tells you the process also. It also then takes you to another level of to use as a training tool, because it gives you the background to whatever is you can see on the screen. It gives you the textual background, so which a trainer can actually prime up and read that, and there's a higher and higher levels to that. So there's a synopsis, and beyond the synopsis, if you actually want to read, so there are judgments and articles and everything, you know, whatever possible a person would want to use for training, those are all available, like Maya said, at the click of a mouse. And I just hope that this will be not just entertaining, but also very informative.
Should be in power is left to be determined by the people.
I want all minorities to have an honorable place in the Union of India.
Declaration was that zamindari would be abolished, for which fair compensation would be paid.
There is no dispute whatsoever that the executive should be separated from the judiciary.
The protagonists of Hindi, in their enthusiasm, have gone too far.
Greatest danger in the future may not be that the center will interfere too much, but that the units may resent the guidance of the center.
The future constitution of India would be a pyramidal structure based on the village panchayats.
I move that the constitution be passed.
Congratulations, Maya. Congratulations to CHRI for an amazing leadership you've shown in an area which needed to be addressed. So I thank you and your entire team and congratulate each one of you who've contributed in any way to make this happen. It's an absolute delight. It's actually touched the core of our hearts. We as police officers who wanted to see this happen and happen yet again and happen ahead, I think you've really touched us and we all are very, very grateful. I'm so happy to see my seniors here and I can tell you all of us who are here have heart in this place. That's what brings us all together. I'm exactly leaving where, Maya, you left us at. What next? And that's what you asked me, perspectives on implementation. Before I come to the... It's very interesting. It's the days of technology. And I was reading this newspaper this morning. You'll be surprised what's... Is this an app? Is this an application? Is this on an app?
That will be coming.
That's an area we now to make it into an app, right? So that's, I think, a part of our implementation. But since we're talking about the app, I'll show you a newspaper this morning of Times of India. And there's a cartoon in the Times of India, page 19. And it said, it's an app for toilet training. There's a child sitting on the toilet seat. You saw that?
No, I didn't.
Okay, it's very interesting. It's an app for... It's a child sitting on a toilet seat. And, you know, it's pressure coming out of both the ears because he's trying to strain. And the mother and the grandmother is looking at the... While the child is on the toilet seat, is reading an application. Reading an application for toilet training. We have... But actually, this is a fact. This technology has actually come down to everything which the child, towards self-training. This is, secondly, another piece, exactly what we're talking about that in step of technology is smartphones, tabs need bed mode for uninterrupted sleep. How every solution or inconvenience today is getting a technology solution. Have a look at this. So you're in step. What your work has done today has decentralized training. From centralized training to teacher-driven to infrastructure-dependent, you have decentralized it. You've democratized training. You've broken monopolies of police training by this. And you write, you are at the starting. You opened the gate. And now there are miles and miles to go. And those miles are here as my mind thought through. First of all, we got 12,806 police stations in India as today, till 5 months ago, as the internet says. So 12,806, and there are another many at the rural level, which means how do we reach this to 12,000 police stations? That's the challenge which you and I have, we as a community have. How you lead it or you collaborate it, I think that would be the stage. Isn't it, Kamal? I think how do we reach this to 12,806? Because we've got to go beyond Delhi, beyond the language, beyond English and Hindi. So here is it that I would think we could go into. Strategy to reach out would be tap the resident welfare associations, villages. That's why an application would be necessary. Once you have the app made of this, it will be not difficult at all. It will be on everybody's mobile phone. Isn't it right, Mr. Rai? This could be an application on the mobile phone where I can drive while driving, read it. So that means it can be application driven on the mobile phone. So make this. So even when you're being driven means that application would be in your hand on the mobile phone. That would be almost 85% of the people as the years go by. So a strategy to reach out is number one, quickly to convert into an application. Reach out through that to everybody then. You democratize it. Then RWA or Nile, ab kisi ka bas bahana nahi hai ki mujhe malum nahi hai thane mein kya hota hai. You've taken that excuse away ki mujhe malum nahi kya karna hai. So villages, educational institutions, training institutions, public schools and police schools itself. So A is how do we increase our reach by application and then also talking about what we already have. Then we convert into all 14 languages. The application will help you convert it. You've got softwares. It will then automatically come into those 14 languages or 12 languages you want to go into. there's a lot of homework. You see, in policing, we pick up the person who delivers. And what do? We make him deliver more. In policing, ye kaam karne wala isi ko do kaam. Aur jo nakamma hai, usko rehne do, chodo. But jo kaam karne wala hai, usko hum dhoondte hain ki isko aur diya jaye. Because the CHRI is asked for work, okay? So 14 languages. Then comes, there's a beginning of a long journey. We now need from police station is the how, what happens if I have, if there's a missing child. That means the public person is trained that if there's a missing child, what do you do? How do you report? I think what's important also is, as the, if you've already incorporated, is what must the FIR have? Full information, even the hulia of the accused. So missing child, what I can think of is, now you look at the police angle also. While you've talked about the citizen angle, look at the police angle. What are they to do? Because that's what is missing. We don't have the best of the trainers today, because training is considered not the best posting. So therefore you don't get the best people in training. Those of us who made it the best is because we thought we were the best. Whenever some of us were posted in police training, we gave our best because we thought we were the best. And we thought that work was the best. And what is before us, we have to make them the best. We believed in ourselves. Not that the that was the reason you were posted to police training, that you were the best. No, probably the most difficult. Therefore, you go to training, right? That's where we were posted. But we thought, therefore, now let's look at it the other way. I'm giving you homework, but I'll give you the solution also, Maya. So don't get worried. So we're looking at vehicle theft, crimes against women, accident prevention or accident reporting, nuisance, etc., etc. Now, when I say all these areas need to be, A, how do you report? What must it contain? Secondly is, what will the police do? Now, those are the checklists we need to do it in the same way. And now the question is, do we wait for next 10 years? Because you could do this in 1 year. You could do this one in 1 year. But we need hundreds. So should we wait for 100 years? No. We can do something very interesting, which is happening in this country. We just have to bring it together. We bring the corporate or social responsibility in this. We bring the IT companies in this. We convene an IT companies congregation. We bring in IT companies for CSR. We bring in IT institutions who are training. We bring training institutions, and we bring CSR. And we bring this work together, and we, of course, bring the National Police Academy, we bring the Bureau of Police Research and Development, BPR&D, NPA, state police academies, and the IT. We need to bring them together. Don't wait, we don't wait for bureaucracy to do that for us. We do it. We do it with you. We all join hands in this future of this country. We, the CHRI, could continue to be in the lead, induct the invite NPA, invite all the state training directors, the state training institutions, bring key IT companies, bring IT training institutions, convene a conference like that and say, who takes what subject? You take auto theft, you take missing child, you take terror crimes, you take reporting. And then we have some standardization. That means you become a trainer now. You train the trainer and you collaborate. That means you don't go it alone anymore. You collaborate. And that is how in the next 2 years, I see an answer in all these issues you're talking about. You've shown the way, but don't go alone the way. Go together now, and it can be very collaborative. So NPA and State Police Training Academies, Bureau of Police Research and Development can bring some resources for you. So it's a collaborative cost, and collaborative cost can come from the corporate social responsibility. So they will get their own benefits. Then enter a police control room. Now let's go to the control room. What happens when a call goes? So let's go through police control room, go through a police van. See, all I'm saying is these are the interesting things you've opened up. You've shown the way, and I think that can happen. So I thought this could be now a collaborative model through BPR&D, NPA, I've already mentioned, assigned tasks to each. I think I want to say we can now look forward to solutions. We're looking forward to quality enhancement in police training through this tool. And as I said, this says the next generation of police training. I would say, the right generation of police training. It's not a day late. Now, not 1 year. Now, simultaneously, it should be the right generation of training, my friends. And I think that is the way forward. Thank you for breaking ice, breaking this mold of conventional training, outdated training, inadequacy of training, and centralized training. You've broken those molds and you've democratized it. And now the challenge now is how much we achieve collaboratively, ensuring absolute quality. Let's hope we meet again maybe 2 years from now. All those IT companies who contributed, all the companies who contributed, the academies who contributed to create these 100 apps, 50 apps, and that's all in your, on your fingertips. Thank you very much.